Good morning, everyone. It is your English class, and today we are going to study our next chapter, chapter number 6, verbs. This chapter we are going to study. Half part of this chapter we studied in our previous class, and rest of part now we are going to study. So let's take a quick revision of this. So first of all, dear student, we understood about the verb. Means what are the verbs? So I told you action words, or like words which shows being and being, and along with this possession, those words are called verbs, right? Then we understood about transitive and intransitive and incomplete verbs. So which verbs need to fulfill object, that is called transitive, and there is no need to mention the object, that is intransitive. Complete verbs, like incomplete verbs are like form of be, is, am, are, was, were, will be, shall be, become, appear. So there is no any action in these verbs. So these verbs are called incomplete verbs. Then I told you about direct and indirect objects. So if you put the question with what answer comes, that is direct object. And if you put the question with whom, what answer comes, that is indirect object. In simple words, we can understand non-living things are direct object and living beings are indirect object. Okay, suppose I say that I gave him my pen. I gave him my pen. Him is indirect object and my pen is direct object. Right. Next, we understood about auxiliary and main verbs. So like be form, do form, have form, will be, shall, will, shall, can, could, may, might, or to, must, dare, need. These all the verbs are called auxiliary. In this, two categories are there: modal auxiliary verbs and helping verbs. Primary auxiliary verbs means which auxiliary verbs we use in tenses. Those are called primary auxiliary verbs, and rest of the verbs are called modal auxiliary verbs. And main verbs, which are the main verbs which are used with the these modal helping verbs or auxiliary or like primary helping verbs, those are called main verbs. Modal helping verbs, we have understood that. Then finite and non-finite, which verbs are changed due to number of the subject or person of the subject or changing of the sentence. If that is changed, that is finite. If that is not changed, that is non-finite. If I say that I want to play cricket, and if I say that I wanted to play cricket, so want is a finite verb, and play is means to play is non-finite verb, because want it has become wanted, but to play, that is same in both the sentences. So which verb is changed, that is finite, and which verb is not changed, that is non-finite. Detail we studied in our previous class. Then there are three main forms of any verb. First is present form, then second is past tense form, and third is past participle form. Okay, present form, past form, and past participle form. These are called first form, second form, and third forms. Then we studied about strong forms and weak forms, like when we have to add ed or d or t to make second and third form. So those verbs are called weak verbs. And when we have to change like internal vowels or like complete formation, those verbs are called strong forms, like laugh, laughed, that is weak form. Come, came, that is strong form. By, bought, that's also strong forms. Then we studied this all the verbs. Okay, then we studied about these weak verbs. Then I told you in English language, some verbs are there of those verbs, second and third forms are same, like bet, 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 like first, second, and third forms are same. Second, cut, 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 put, 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 split, split, split. So all the forms of these verbs are same. Some troublesome verbs. I told you some verbs are there and which confuse us, like bone and bone. Beer, beer is a verb. And second and third form, beer, bore, bone, and beer, bore, bone. In pronunciation, third form is same, but in spelling, you can see that there is a difference. So when we talk about to give birth, so that is third form is born. When we talk about to carry, means le jana, so that third form is born. Second, हैंग वर्ब इज देयर इफ वी टॉक अबाउट किसी चीज को लटकाना सो हैंग हंग हंग इफ यू टॉक अबाउट किसी को फांसी देना दैट इज हैंग हंग हंग नाउ वी हैव कम ऑन दिस पेज पेज नंबर दैट इज 45 सो वी नीड टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर लेट्स स्टार्ट सो हियर इट इज रिटन lie word is there lie has flowing forms so to rest or remain to speak falsely lie ka meaning hota hai late na aur second meaning hota hai iska jhoot bolna so when we talk about to rest means late na so lie lay lane second form is lay third form is lane but when we talk about lie means jhoot bolna lie lied lied so we need to remember I was tired so I lay यहाँ पे मैं बात कर रहा हूँ लेटने की तो वो थका हुआ था सो आई ले डाउन फॉर अ लिटिल व्हाइल टू रेस्ट मींस मीनिंग ऑफ दिस ले इज टू रेस्ट सेकंड इज लेट मी लाई हियर मींस लेट मी रिमेन मींस लेटने दो आई नो यू लाई टू मी मींस टू स्पीक फॉल्सली मींस झूठ बोलना टू ले मींस टू पुट अ प्लेस समथिंग डाउन इट्स फॉर्म्स आर ले इज ऑल्सो बेस फॉर्म Like we saw here, lay second form of lie when we talk about to take rest. But lay is first form also, when lay is there, first form is there, it means kuch rakhna, like lay, laid, laid. Right? Kindly lay the child in the bed. Right? I forgot where I had laid the purse. So we need to remember these verbs also. When lay is present tense form, it means it is to place, but it is also the past tense of lie. Same thing I have told you. Fell. Fell is the past tense of fall. She collided with a cycle and fell down. So we know that it's the second form of fall. Fall, fell, fallen. So, but second point is that, but fell is also used in present tense. Then its meaning is to cause something to fall and its form are. So you dear students, we need to know that fall word, F-A-L-L, fall. Fall meaning is girna. And fell, when F-E-L-L, fell is base form that it means that girana. So fell, felled, felled, fall, fell, fallen. We need to learn these all the verbs. See, like they felled the trees quite thoughtlessly. So there we need to put the meaning girana. The wrestler felt him down quite easily. Same meaning. So is the past tense of see. So jo word hai, usi ki second form hai. I saw a large crowd, but so is also used in present tense. Then its meaning is to cut and its form are sow, sowed and sown. Really sowed also. So, dear student, we know that C is first form. C means dekhna, see, so, seen. But so is first form also. Right? When it meaning is to cut any wood. So, sowed, sowed, or sown. These are the second and third form of so word. The carpenter sowed the log of wood. So, carpenter ne ek wood ke log ko, ek tukde ko kaat diya. Rise and raise. To rise means to get up or to come up. To raise means to lift. Rise ka meaning hota hai uthana. Sometimes I say you please raise your hand. So rise ka matlab uthna, raise ka matlab uthana. Sometimes I say to you please raise your hand. So raise means uthana, rise means uthna. All of us will rise to welcome the chief guest. Means to get up. The sun rise in the east to come up or get up. We raised our hands in the prayers to lift, right? So these words we need to remember. So dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, you have to do the next exercise, okay? So exercise one you have to do. Come in this exercise and let's see that what's written here. So give the past and past participle form for oral practice. So dear students, in this tense, you need to tell, basically, there is no need to do this exercise in your notebook. Just for oral practice, you have to do this exercise, right? In this exercise, you need to write the second and third form. Means like you have to speak out the third form or second form of these all the verbs, okay? Now please come on the second exercise. rewrite the flowing passage using the past tense of the verb given in the brackets. So this passage you have to rewrite means second form you have to write, because past tense we know that we need to use second form. So in this passage, verbs are written in the brackets. So these verbs you have to write in second form, like young Ravi shift into a new house. So you need to say that young Ravi shifted into a new house with an old tree in the backyard. Many birds flocked to tree and he enjoyed the sight. Every day he heard them chirp and spread their colorful wings. So in this way, dear student, you have to write the second form of this all the verbs, right? Now please come on the third exercise. Solve the flowing puzzle using the past participle of the verb given in the clues. So past participle, you know that is a third form. So we need to write the third form of in this puzzle. Cross means left to right. Word is flee. Flee means bhag jana. So third form is fled. Third form is fled. So we need to write here F-L-E-D. In same way, bear means carry. So in this, we have to write here bone, third form, B-O-R-N-E. Five letters we need to put B-O-R-N-E, bone, right? So in this way, you have to do this exercise number third. Now please come on the M point means formation. Formation of verb. We can form verbs from nouns. So by the help of nouns also we can form the verbs like courage, encourage, friend, befriend, class, classify. So courage, friend, class, these are the nouns. And encourage, befriend, classify, these are the verbs. So we have to understand this point here. With the help of nouns, we can make some verbs by adding some prefix, okay? From adjectives also we can make some verbs like rich, enrich, fresh, refresh, loose, loosen, modern, modernize. Okay, let us learn how verbs are formed with the help of some common prefixes and suffixes. In some cases, while adding a suffix into a word, we may have to alter its spelling slightly. So dear students, sometimes it happens we have to add the prefix or suffix. Prefix means which letters are added in the starting, and suffix means which letters are added in the last of that word. And some spelling we have to alter, and we have to add the prefix and we get a verb like able, enable, courage, encourage, dear, endear, large, enlarge, circle, encircle, danger, endanger, joy, enjoy, sure, ensure. So by adding only en, we have made many verbs. Now please come on the next page. Prefix be, full, be full, head, be head, friend, be friend, little, be little. So these are the verbs. By adding en are also, like we can say broad, broaden, dark, darken, fright, frighten, haste, hasten, loose, loosen, red, redden, white, whiten, cheap, cheapen, deep, deepen, glad, gladden, length, lengthen, mad, madden, thick, thicken, wide, widen, apology, apologize, critic, criticize, memory, memorize, special, specialize, civil, civilize, equal, equalize, real, realize, sympathy, sympathize, beauty, beautify, by adding fy, clear, clarify, horrify, peace, pacify, class, classify, glory, glorify, just, justify, pure, purify, bath, bathe, breathe, breath, company, accompany, find, refine, fresh, refresh, sale, sell, blood, bleed, cloth, cloth, custom, accustom, food, feed, prison, imprison, tell, tell, right? So these are the verbs. So dear students, now on the behalf of this understanding, we have to do exercise number 4. So fill in the blanks with the verb from the words given in the bracket. So these verbs are given in the bracket. So these verbs you have to fill as a form of verb. Okay. So it will take me some time to myself to these change. So we can say here, it will take me some time to accustom myself to these changes. Next, don't just with people, help them if you can. Don't just, we can say here, sympathize. Don't just sympathize with people. By sympathy, we have made this word sympathize. With people, help them if you can. Next, our team was able to the score in the second half. So equal word is there. So we can mention here. Our team was able to equalize the score in second half. So verbs we have to make and we have to use it. 3 I have told you, and rest of these sentences you will do by yourself. And now this chapter is completed. So now we need to understand about one letter. So second letter also we will understand. And so for this, you are advised to open the page number 207. Open in this page. And we are going to understand the second letter. Letter number E. So let's understand this. Write a letter to the station house officer reporting the theft of your cycle. So this letter is formal letter because you are not going to write this letter to your relatives or to your friends. To a station office or house officer, you are going to write a letter. So that letter is called formal letter. Okay. So same, first of all, we need to write the sender address. So here you have to write your address. Firstly, house number, then your street name, then your like colony name, then your village or city name you can mention. After that, you have to leave one line. Then you have to mention today's date. Okay, 6 May 2021. Okay, or in this way also you can mention May 6th, 2021. Then again, you have to leave one line. Then you have to write the receiver address. In this, you need to remember that we do not need to write the name of the receiver because in formal letter, we don't know like what is his name. So just his designation we mention to whom we are going to write. Just designation we mention, not name. So we are going to write the station house officer. Even we don't know his name. So just we mention his designation and then address. Then again, we need to leave one line. Then we can say, dear sir, again, we have to leave one line. Then we have to tell the matter. So this letter, basically you have to write the letter to the station house officer reporting the theft of your cycle. So your cycle has been stolen. Regarding this, you need to write a letter. So let's read. At about 11 o'clock this morning, I went to Angan restaurant on the Ramshaha path. I parked my cycle just near the entrance. When I came out after 20 minutes, I was shocked to find my cycle missing. I made inquiries from the shopkeepers around and looked for my cycle everywhere in neighborhood, but it was untraceable. It is a new hero cycle bearing the number B143893. Among accessories, it has a bell, a lamp, and a gear wheel case. It's of dark blue color. I shall be grateful to you if you help in tracing the cycle and restoring it to me. Yours faithfully, Onkar. So here you need to write your name. So dear student, you can notice that someone cycle has been stolen and he's writing a letter to the station house officer. So firstly, he's just telling the situation. He told in this letter, time was 11 o'clock. He went in Angan restaurant, which is in Ramesh path, at the Ramesh path. So then he is telling that he parked his cycle there near the entrance. Then he is telling that after some minutes, he came back and he was shocked because his cycle was not there. Then he is telling that he inquired about the cycle in the neighborhood, but he did not find his cycle. Then he is giving the description of his cycle. The color of the cycle was blue color, and the number of cycle was B143893, and accessory was a bell, a lamp, and gear wheel. So in the last line, she is requesting to find or to trace his cycle. Okay, so in the last, we need to mention here your signature. Okay, so dear student, in this way, like we write the formal letter. Again, I tell you, first of all, center address. Then we have to leave one line. Then we have to mention today's date, on which day we are going to write the letter. Then we have to mention the receiver address. In receiver address, we should not write the name of the receiver. Just designation we mention. Then we have to leave one line. Then dear sir, then information, what information we want to convey. And the last, you can mention here, subscription means like yours faithfully, and then you have to mention your name. Okay, so in this way, dear students, you have to write this letter in your notebook, and then you have to learn. I'm telling you, in notebook you have to write, then you have to learn. Okay, so